previously on the protest contest.
It is time to bust the moon.
Democracy Spring, this is an action happening right now.
Civil disobedience?
Great, that sounds like a lot of fun.
Spring to go. Yeah, I couldn't see what could be more dramatic than 1,000 people going to jail from the Capitol building from Philadelphia to Washington.
To change the way that the message gets across so that people actually have a transformational experience, have a new way of looking at the world, to have a way of making it so.
Welcome back to the Protest Contest, the second edition of our transgenre video series, Conversation with Activism. History is definitely still happening.
Democracy Spring people have performing sit-ins since Monday. On the first day, there were more than 400 people arrested. It was unprecedented. Capitol Police said they have never arrested that many people in a sit-in here at the Capitol.
Part of a movement is that you must be moved to complete the circuit. Concern activated, turned into action, to apply yourself to what is unfolding, to take the next step.
I'm Echo Lake, Devin Kyle Irby, and I today, with Bill Henry, sit in solidarity with Democracy Spring.
The country will stay the same. I will become different.
People need to see more, you know, boldness and creativity.
We are unstoppable. Another world is possible.
We, so we can topple the empire and destroy the fascists and kill capitalists.
Come join the fun. And besides that, they're great people doing this stuff.
I'd love to get money out of politics. Elizabeth Croydon. I'm in from the Evil Do-Gooder radio show. And I'm running for Congress in Maryland District 8. I'm the Green Party.
Another world is possible. We are unstoppable. Another world is possible.
We need immediacy. We need to replace the media.
Turn off your televisions, folks.
We are the ones inheriting our political and economic process. And we can turn this around overnight if enough of us are ready and willing to put our bodies on the line and give a damn. Right now we're living an amazing time where we're all connected through social media and the internet, and we're able to communicate messages like we've never been able to do that before. And we can use that for great disruptive purposes in creating a new world and disrupting the old.
It's the information age. Ignorance is a choice now. You can find out the truth, but you're not going to find it out from the idiot box.
No, is that corporations make erasing our democracy. So oligarchy must go. What is what we have to break? TV news we seldom make, cause we haven't got the go.
Well, electoral reform, yeah, oh yeah, that's sexy. That's like reading a car manual, okay?
We talked about whether it made sense to go, and we're like, you know, this is just such an important issue. This is like the first issue.
Until we solve it, it's going to make it a lot harder to deal with any of the other things that we're all concerned about.
It needs to happen in order for all of the other issues that people are trying to accomplish to be able to happen.
Climate change, racial justice, mass incarceration, any of that stuff.
The amount of heat we are putting out into the atmosphere out of balance with the natural order is equivalent to 400,000 Hiroshima atomic bombs being detonated every single day, 5 every single second.
Prison reform, immigration, you know, Medicare being able to negotiate with Big Pharma.
1 to 200 species of animals are going extinct every single day.
Our ridiculous taxation system, the subsidies to big ag, the problem with oil and gas, the fact that we're not doing the climate change stuff. I mean, you just go on and on and on.
Yeah, you verbalize them rather well.
to make that list.
When you start learning about the documents upon which this country was founded and how far away we've strayed from that, and you get actually passionate about politics.
When people like you come out and unite together, I mean, this is a rainbow of people. This is America.
For over 40 years, our human family has been fulfilling a prophecy.
This feather's gonna go around.
That a tribe that would be radically accepting, that would embrace all cultures, all solutions, and be able to speak truth to power would emerge. The Hopi prophecy calls for a rainbow people to emerge when there are the waters are black and the birds are falling from the sky. These things have all come to pass. So we're here. Rainbow Gathering of Living Light is 40-something years. There's no money exchanged. It's about, there's two operating systems. There's capitalism. You can be replaced by a number. And family. Your happiness is my happiness.
I was a lifelong Republican.
Yeah.
All the hues of humanity are needed for the solution.
Well, we need to come together, everybody, the Occupy movement and the Tea Party, on this bus. And once we create a level playing field, then we can have at it and see how the country ought to go. But for right now, this is the most important thing we can be doing.
I don't have a, you know, we'll do this-ism and it will work so much better. No, just be adaptive, be like water.
I'm just trying to listen to the people around me. Think like water, you can go with the flow.
To shape yourself to the situation. Be adaptive. Don't be really rigid. It's the rigidity that will break in the winds of change.
It's our festival and circus to the People's Party. You know, called out the defunct system. We put them on notice. We said, this is our house, and we knocked at the door repeatedly and asked them to open up the doors, and they didn't.
You are subject to arrest. If you are not looking to be arrested, move on the other side of the police officers and towards the grass.
The old party's over. We've declared it. It's done. So here we are in the Unplugged No Click gloaming.
Mm-hmm.
After our ARC 38 appearance here at Democracy Spring. Get our magic on, you know. We marched.
Oh, you can't scare me, I'm sticking to the union. I'm sticking to the union. I'm sticking to the union. Oh, you can't scare me, I'm sticking to the union. I'm sticking to the union till the day I die.
Izzy from Omega.
I am coming to the ARC. I'm Izzy, and I'm marching down the street with my friend Karen, and she got arrested yesterday, and I'm getting arrested today.
Oh, wait, here it is.
Yes, okay.
There I am, arrested yesterday. Peaceful protest.
This is 2 weeks, because I walked from Philadelphia last week, and then I'm doing this, and I got arrested today.
Okay.
So that's the first time in my life that I ever did anything like that.
I've been arrested twice, and I'm going to get arrested again today.
Democracy Springs campaign to get money out of politics. And why I personally marched and participated in the sit-ins is because I believe that kids should have more rights than corporations.
And I was arrested on Monday and Tuesday.
One passion, but they're all connected.
It's just tragic that people aren't civically engaged.
And so I decided to do the march. Started on April 2nd in Philly and walked 140 miles along with more than 100 people from at least 24 states.
And it was a lot of peanut butter and jelly sandwiches and very tired feet and sleeping on the ground, but people helping each other and walking along together and telling stories and getting to know each other.
The arrest procedures itself were kind of like a gigantic choreography of justice.
On Monday there were over 400, and Monday they had each officer arrested 10 people. That's why we got the wristbands. And then the officer would get the same color so they could keep track of us.
And says, okay, do you understand that if you don't leave right now, you are going to be arrested, and you either nod and accept this on your, or else that you say, okay, no, never mind, I didn't really want to do
it. It was a great experience there. There were 400 people. We were in a big warehouse after we were arrested.
The first day with the largest crowd, the police gave orders so fast.
We all get up onto the steps. The cops come and give us one warning.
By the time we sat down and unfurled the big banner, I had just heard like a third order. This is your third order. Like, it happened super fast.
Shut it down!
every day, the elderly day, it happens so fast. The elders sit down, this is your first, this is your second, this is your third order. And what tends to happen the first 2 days is people backed up really quick and the police line.
They frisked us, and each person had to stand in line with the officer next to them, and they were very much treating us like criminals.
While we were waiting, it was a feeling of solidarity, seeing all the other people around who had also chosen to take that step towards regaining their voice.
This is one of the best ways to participate. It feels a lot more rewarding than voting.
Then we were bused to a big sort of warehouse. They had the women sit on one side and the men sit on the other side.
In processing, we connected with the officers and explained the situation, and they're all with us. And talking to officers, trying to push the line, and every one of them are like, yeah, we like what you're doing, and we need money out of politics, and there's too much corruption.
We shall not be moved. We shall end corruption. We shall not be moved. We shall end corruption, we shall not be moved, just like a tree that's planted by the water. We shall not be moved.
Hope for more creativity, to use this momentum and use this to make something happen this week, or just show the boldness, show the people that they can get out here and there and do this to get money out of politics, and it's just not going to be like a kiddie cookie cutter sit-in the whole time. Show the masses of people who just signed up and are here and this is their first experience that, yeah, we can push harder within the boundaries of even the current law.
If they do come up to Philadelphia to talk with me, and if they decide, I think they call that a bench for it, I call it a conversation.
And we wait for the training to get out, the morning training, which starts at 9 a.m. each day. And they walk from a church down the block. When the training arrives, we cheer them on and the rally starts. Different speakers according to the theme of the day.
On labor was the theme today.
Another champion of democracy, Congressman Hank Johnson.
Good morning, brothers and sisters, who understand what's at stake, who understand what it takes in order to make change. And so we've gotten so much corruption in terms of the ideals that were enshrined in the preamble have been slowly eroded over the years. Those same corporate interests that are setting the policies, they want to keep us from voting. And we can't do it alone in the ivory tower of the Capitol. We have to have people like you. You're disrupting things. You are making a difference. And so I want to applaud you, and I want you to know that don't think that you are all by yourself and that nobody's listening in the ivory tower. Yeah, we're listening. You actually give us strength for the measures that we're trying to introduce and get passed. But we will prevail. We'll change America, and it's not going to happen in 10 years. It's going to happen soon, much sooner than that. So thank you so much for everything you're doing.
It's good to know that there are some good people in the government who are doing their best. Well, we went to see Peter Welch, who's a representative from Vermont, to get his, you know, it's fine to be on the streets, but to go talk to your representatives is really, really important. That you dare to be there and talk to them and give them your ideas. Well, I don't feel like I'm there making a big change, but it gives me a feeling that there's a face to this government.
So let me tell you about the march and the action. You have the signs visible to all the cameras, so you march, and then you have those few moments with those cameras to try to get impressions. And it's, you know, so some people, there's a few big banners, two big parachutes, and the conch shell was useful and respected and appreciated.
Hey, I love your car. I'm 68 years old, and I want to get my government back. I want to be able to have elections that nobody can buy.
Overturn! Citizens United! Overturn! Citizens United! Overturn! Citizens United!
Thank you very much, construction workers. You're doing a great job.
We're here for you. We're fighting for you.
Money up! Money up!
then while I'm giving my mic check,
checks, and that's where I really spoke my truth to the people who were there. And then we get turned around the corner, there's a kettle, and then everybody takes their turn signing them. They just have like a fold-out desks and all these officers like lined up taking people and writing out, filling out their tickets and giving us our golden tickets. A decision to not pay your $50 and ask for an arraignment for a court date. Make sure everyone got their IDs back, and off we go back to the crowds.
So it's building a very, very, very special community was the high point.
The future's an inside job, so we had this beautiful circle. Powerful, heartfelt, every single person. So then we made it back to the tent, to the base. Saw a lot of young folks who were potentially ready to do more. So I said, you know, mic check, anybody who wants to, you know, thank you for being here, participation, thank you to the organizers and the marchers and the people arrested, we're all playing our part, blah, blah, blah. Journalists, thank you, everybody sitting there buzzing and tweeting and whatevering, or undercovering.
To live, to work, to express your highest quality.
All right, so look at the 10 principles of Burning Man. These are how to optimize the collective mind, to tap the collective wisdom. What we're really here about is the right use of power.
May we maintain the power of awareness, paradigm shift throughout this journey.
When people learn to trust, learn to be a trustworthy person, we're each cells of a larger entity.
I pass the conch shell around twice. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Twice around the circle. Who are they? What are they here for? What do they stand for? What's next? What would they like to see?
We need a fight. If one of us doesn't have equal power to fight this.
And it was amazing. Extraordinary.
It's for the world to realize that honesty will benefit everyone in the long run, as much as it may hurt in the short run.
I feel like this is a pivotal moment for not just this movement, but for all movements, for humanity in general. And if we don't get it together real soon, we're going to be in trouble.
So, grassroots and community organizing is extremely important.
It's not subjective, it's not objective, it's omnijective. Everybody's mind is thrown at least a tiny piece into what we've created.
What I want is to really find myself before I get too shaped by society.
Reality or just general, just a poor community. If you feel comfortable doing so, go in and help out.
Yeah, I support my Muslim neighbors. This is the shirt I wear to my local mosque. Whenever something happens around the world, or even something locally, like a bad sentencing or conviction, and I just share with them and ask them, check in with them, whether they need more, they need my support, or they're feeling threatened, or if there's anything I can do to stand up for them. I just go to my little teeny mosque on my corner and do that, and it's very rewarding. It's almost selfish.
Whether it be, you know, getting free breakfast to whatever it may be, maybe holding Know Your Rights workshop, just getting into the community and being able to help out, and maybe a community garden is another great idea.
Peace worldwide could be reality. There's no need for war. And the reason for war is there are different cultures who live in different parts of the world. That doesn't make one correct or one incorrect. It's just different. Right? And so we all have our right to be different, and our personal liberty is everything.
Seriously, no. We ain't never gonna give up until we win.
So just to wake up as many people as I possibly can on every single level, keep the momentum, keep the passion, the drive, and really move this forward, make it work, and make sure that everyone's got a better life in front of them as a result.
I tell you, the more that you all grow, the more that you take action, the closer we get to victory. Continue to fight. Don't let anything get between you. Don't let disunity take hold. Stay unified, stay motivated. You're doing the right thing. And together, ladies and gentlemen, we will prevail.
And the people have had enough. People of the world, the indigenous world, the native world, the living world, our Mother Gaia, stand together and sit in solidarity with Democracy Spring, with the Truth Awakening,
Let's do it.
We ain't never gonna give up.